And back at our headquarters, coming off of our best race of the season at Canada with a P9 finish, our first points of the season. Going over to our facilities, we have 1.3 million in the bank. Pit equipment. I wanna save up money to do fabrication so I'm able to have more R&D going at the same time. 1700 R&D points, but as you can see, don't have anything or any space. This is free, but we can't do it because our department's at capacity. And yeah, corporate can't do it. We're P8 in constructors. We have time to reach Alfa Romeo. P14 in the driver standings, that we're nowhere close to being P1. Let's head on over to activities. Do supplier HQ tour. Aero equipment. And PR filming. Alright. It's advanced time. Got okay. Upgrades coming
the
through.
New parts come through the fabrication process. We have them with us for the next right. Company. We need your input here.
Who do I consider choice. My rival? I guess we'll go Alonso. Even though we probably can't keep up with him. What is happening? I'm stuck in the screen.
Thanks for stepping in and helping handle that.
Okay, that was weird. Let's head over to our... Actually, I'll just advance time. Actually, let's just do it now. Oh, yeah, okay. Let's do this. Oh, wow. It's gonna take us 3 races to do it, but we are in desperate need of it. Can't do that. More aero, rear downforce. Let's wait on discounts. Alright. Advance time again. No, cylinder head.
I know we were expecting some new developments to come through, but some of them have failed quality control. We need to tell the team what to redevelop.
Oh, I don't even have
R&D screen.
Oh man. That's supposed to be our major upgrade before Silverstone. Alright, we're gonna have to wait. Nose cone is all good. Alright, still behind Alpine in the vehicle performance comparison, but we're getting there. We're getting there. Alright, other than that, let's head on to Silverstone.
Only got 2 laps of fuel left. return once again then to the home of British motorsport and the birthplace of the Formula One World Championship. It's race day here at Silverstone, and it's time for the British Grand Prix. Silverstone circuit then is 3.6 miles long, has a total of 18 corners, and of course is no stranger to the rain. There won't be any DRS available in these conditions, but the Wellington and Hangar straights are still good opportunities to tuck into the slipstream and make a pass. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Charles Leclerc lines up on pole position, and the smooth operator Carlos Sainz completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Russell, Max Verstappen, and Norris. Ricciardo, Ocon, Magnussen, and Valtteri Bottas. Perez, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Gasly, Goose, and Fernando Alonso. Tsunoda, Mick Schumacher, Sebastian Vettel, and Alex Albon. Stroll, Joe, Armstrong, and Nicholas Latifi. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. With the Grand Prix nearly upon us, Anthony Davidson is by my side once again to offer his perspective. Can we start by having a chat about Sergio Perez? As ever, the threat of unreliability is never far away, and indeed, they'll be starting out of position today due to power unit component changes. It's going to be a difficult task to move forward from there.
Everyone has to deal with penalties or reliability issues from time to time throughout their career. You just have to suck up the pain and get on with the job at hand. Today isn't about performing a miracle to put the car back where it should be. It's about effective damage limitation.
Here we go then, the formation lap is underway. These are wet conditions here today. Each driver will no doubt be mindful of the wet surface as they prepare to race around the track.
gap ahead is 2.6 seconds. They're on a fresh set of inters. Their tyres are just one lap old. We think they've got one more stop. And the time last lap was a 1:42.0. Careful with the front wing, you've taken some minor damage. Okay, no issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Mate, that brings you up a place. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 2.7 seconds. Rain is going to be with us for a while now. Dries definitely seem like the fastest tyre at the moment. Our gap to the car in front is 5.3 seconds. players ahead of you. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 8.0 seconds. They're on old intermediates. Their tyres are 5 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. Your last lap time was a 1 minute 37.0. We're 2.5 seconds slower right now. Come on. Seconds. Light rain will stay with us for at least 20 minutes, maybe more. Light rain is here to stay. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Copy. Green flag. Some tire grip anytime now. laps until the pit window opens, you'll be on inters for the next stint. Gap to your teammate behind is 3.9 seconds. Magnussen ahead. Okay, gap ahead is 15.1 seconds. They're on old intermediates. Okay, they've done 10 laps on those tyres. We think they've got one more stop. Time last lap was a 1:37.1. They're pulling away from us at a rate of 1.8 seconds a lap. Give it everything. That's Alonso behind. Okay, the gap is less than a second. They're on old intermediates. Okay, they've done 10 laps on those tyres. We think they've got one more stop. And the time last lap was a 1:38.4. Push hard on the inlap. You're dropping a second a lap to the car behind. 1 second. Okay, there seems to have been a problem attaching the right front wheel. We need to try and put that behind us though and finish the race strong. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Minutes of light rain. Front is 24.9 seconds. Marcus is coming in for his stop now. for a while. Light rain conditions for the foreseeable future. Okay, not sure whether tries or inters are faster. We're right on the crossover. Dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Well done. Vettel's ahead of you. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 2.9 seconds. They're on a fresh set of inters. Their tyres are 3 laps old. Your last lap time was a 1:37.1. Okay, we're dropping back by around 4/10 a lap. Give it everything you got. And gap to the car in front is 3.0 seconds. P15. Vettel ahead. Okay, gap ahead is 4.2 seconds. They're on old intermediates. Okay, Zhu's behind you now. Less than a second separates you. They're on old intermediates. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Okay, 7 laps to go. Front is 4.9 seconds. No tyre concerns at the moment, just focus on the driving. Of time to the car behind, let's keep pushing. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. information on Stroll. Okay, it looks like the problem's terminal. They're retiring the car. By 3.2 seconds. Front is 10.5 seconds.
Done a brilliant job, I must say, under some intense pressure to take a well-earned victory here at the British Grand Prix. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
Rain always has the potential to liven up a race and mix up the order, and they've taken full advantage of that to claim the victory today. It's always a bit of a lottery when the conditions are like this, but they've managed to stay on circuit and have come out on top.
at it again. An excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there. Let's take a look at the driver standings. Charles Leclerc.
And there you have it. Charles Leclerc P1, Carlos Sainz P2, Lewis Hamilton P3. We finish in P15 after starting in P13, getting all the way up to P9, P8, and then hanging on to P10 after Norris DNFs. Then a slow pit stop causes us to fall down to P15, where we ultimately stayed for the rest of the race. Clearly our race pace in the wet weather is very slow. Not sure why, but we move on. Potential for points today, but didn't come to reality. And yeah, that's life.